we don't meet here. So she's Federica and he is Andrea. And how about last year, we had to choose what to do in our 1 year internship. And when I say I wanted to go to the bioinformatics lab, I got a couple of entertaining reactions from my friends. And also some others that we will not comment. And basically, they were all questioning my sanity. And that's because, well, it makes sense because we were studying biology. And so my friends that are now all working in research, she's in immunology, he's in crystallography, just really hate staying behind the computer as much as I hate staying in a lab. And also, all the time that I spend behind the computer trying to solve some crazy dependency, some crazy installation is wasted time for them because that's not what they are supposed to do. They are supposed to do research. And so, fast forward some years, I'm actually working on a project, CyVerse UK, that between these other faculties, I suppose they want to help my friends with these issues. So a key role in our project is played by Docker, and I'm not going to explain what it is because I guess at this moment you all more or less know what I'm talking about. But I'm going to tell you something more about CyVerse UK. CyVerse UK is the first branch of a well-established US project that is led by the University of Arizona and PAC in Texas. And the aim is to give any researcher, even without any affiliation, access to HPC resources for their analysis. Also, CyVerse make an effort to ensure reproducibility of analysis through hard versioning and extend by open science, distributing all the documentation and the code. And by last, I say we want all of this to be easy for the end user. So I'm going to be happy again. And so that's why they don't have to use command line unless they want to, but we have some nice graphic interface that you discover in the environment on the left. That basically is just a web form that you have to fill in with the parameter and the files that you want to use. And there are actually more web applications that, like specific, for example, for specific for CyVerse UK or for single projects. And why did you choose to use Docker? So first of all, it's easy and fast to use, both for us as developers and for the users. And also, there is already a huge availability of bioinformatics tools. So last time I checked, BioContainers was already distributing more than 2,000 bioinformatics tools. And on the other side, Docker allow us to have reproducible applications. And is lightweight and portable. So if we have to change something in our system, we can be reasonably sure that everything is going to work kind of like the same, hopefully. So I'll give you an overview of our infrastructure. We have a master node, the one in the middle, that is where we have developers and others part of the developer can log in and register applications. This master node is the one that actually submits jobs to the Condor cluster, that is where the Docker container lives. And this cluster can communicate with the storage system. While, if you can see from the picture, users can never directly interact with our machines. So all of these are virtual machines that live in OpenStack. And the final users can only interact through the Agave API and submit a job request to the main node or upload and download file from our storage system. What we would like to have in the future is to have more involvement from the users so that they can develop their own applications, their own Docker images, and we can start using them. This comes with a couple of problems that I will mention later though. So the first step to make all of this work is to make our images publicly available. And that's what we do in the Docker Object Registry under the CyVerse UK organization. All of our images are automatically built from GitHub, so the Docker files are available to the users. And what we would like for the future is including images from third party, like our users, or for example, BioContainers. But, this has has some problems, and so it's still not the hotel dynamic applies that. So we are actually using Condor. So Condor is a management system that provides job queuing mechanisms, scheduling, policy, priority scheme, resource monitoring, and resource management. What's actually interesting for us is that Docker also has a really good integration with Docker. And so submitting Docker jobs is very easy. You have just to write a simple script like this one, specifying that you want to use the universe Docker. And there are a couple of features that I would like to point out here. First of all the images have to be tagged. So we use latest in our images, but we never use it in our applications because we want to be sure that what's finding in Condor is actually what we look. And the first thing is the executable. The executable is optional because you can use the entry point of your Docker image. And the third one is the transfer input file and transfer output files. This, according to me, is the most interesting setting because, as you can see, there's no volume here. And that's because Condor doesn't have volumes in the way we are used to think about them. But it mounts the Scratch directory, kind of like volume. So all the new files that you create in the Scratch directory, in the working directory, will be transferred back. But if you create something that you need in another directory or in a subdirectory, you will have to tell Condor that you want them back. And the other interesting thing is that submitting the job like this, the Docker container actually has job nature, so you can use all Condor tools and commands to deal with the container. And we found some problem working with Condor and Docker that we're not expecting, especially about file permission. We found out that some Docker images that were working absolutely fine, both of on our laptops and in virtual machines, were actually not working because executable permission were not enough. 777 was needed. We are not sure why is that. And that's one of the problem to use a third party image. So all of the images actually have to be tested in Condor. Another problem is that we checked some images for bioinformatics tool, and the images already existing are way bigger than what's actually needed. So as we expect to scale up the number of users, so we don't really want to keep downloading big images all the time. So we all know that Docker was not born to be used on HPC system, so it has some security concerns and not even bugs, but just it was not its purpose. So why we are not concerned about privileged installation is why, as I told you before, our users can never interact directly with machines. So we don't really have more users in the machines. And both the Agave API and the web application have a lot of validators in place. And also we have a granularity port opening and closure opening on our virtual machine. What can constitute a problem is involve the user in providing Docker images, and that's why for the future we are looking into Singularity, so that the users can be involved directly in providing deploying applications.